Good morning, everyone. Welcome back once again. You know very well in the last 4 to 5 sessions, we have done the complex numbers. Today, as you can see, we'll be doing the quadratic equations. Chapter name is quadratic equations. In few books, it will be actually theory of equations. Quadratic or theory. Yeah, it should be there in your Cengage material also as theory of equations. It includes all the equations with degrees 2, 3, 4 and so on. Right, so shall we start the class? Everyone knows that a quadratic equation general form is ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. So the general form of a quadratic equation is ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. And you also know that the roots of this equation actually are x equal to minus b plus r minus under root of b square minus 4ac by how much? 2a. So these are the roots. Okay. And in fact, you got this in your NCERT textbook itself. The roots of the quadratic equation minus b plus r minus root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. You come across one word which is called as discriminant here. What is discriminant? Delta. It is given as b square minus 4ac. And you know very well that delta, based upon delta, you can decide the nature of the roots. The nature of the roots can be real, the roots can be imaginary, the roots can actually be what? Equal. There are three types actually. So this is what only you have got in your NCERT. But when we do the problems in Cengage material or any other material, you need to know more and more. So as the situation comes, as per to the question, I will be explaining with the theory and whatever the new concepts you are going to learn here, better you take down in a notebook. Okay. So this is what actually you have learned, where delta is called as the discriminant. It can also be denoted by D. It can also be denoted by D, capital D, delta or D. Okay. Now, let us see what is, if you just go through the Cengage material, like there he had given in detail the theory of what, the quadratic equations and nth degree equation also. So based upon delta, based upon the value of delta, we can decide the roots. That is, delta value can be like, it can be greater than 0, or it can be equal to 0, or it can be less than 0. So there are three roots. What it is? Delta, I should say here, which is nothing but known as discriminant. Discriminant. If delta is greater than 0, you say that the roots are real. Right. Here also, with delta equal to 0, the roots are equal. And in this case, you say that the roots are imaginary. The roots are imaginary. Depending upon what? Depending upon the value of the discriminant, we can decide the nature of the roots. Delta greater than 0, delta equal to 0, and delta less than 0. Now, I hope you know this one also. Right. Suppose if delta greater than 0, then there are two cases. First case is what? That delta value, delta is a perfect square. A perfect square. Delta is not a perfect square. Delta is not a perfect square. Okay. If delta is a perfect square, then what happens is you get the roots as rational. If delta is not a perfect square, you get the roots as irrational. So you have to remember that if delta is a perfect square only, the roots will become rational. Because square root of perfect square, according to formula, minus b plus r minus under root of b square minus 4ac by 2a, root of b square minus 4ac, if it becomes a perfect square root of a perfect square gets cancelled and you don't get any irrational term there. And that's the reason why we say that the roots will become rational. Suppose if it is not a perfect square, I mean to say, if it is, say, for example, root 5 is actually not at all rational, it is irrational, and therefore the roots which you get actually will be here, the irrational. Okay, now if you just see here, that irrational roots general form is what? A plus root B. If A plus root B is one root, then A minus root B will become another root. Because you should remember that in an nth degree equation, polynomial equation, the irrational roots occur in pairs. That is, if A plus root B is one root, then A minus root B will become the other root. So this is actually about the nature. When we talk actually about the equal roots, so where can we get those equal roots actually? We will be getting equal roots only when delta value is equal to zero. I'm talking about delta greater than zero, then two cases. Delta less than zero, anyhow, you are getting actually two roots. And those two roots are imaginary. A plus IB is one root, A minus IB will become the other root. Irrational roots and the complex roots, they will be occurring in pairs actually. Okay. So this is actually about the rational roots, irrational roots. Now comes actually another doubt. Sir, when do we say that the roots are integers and the roots are rational numbers? Here, you know that the general form of a quadratic equation is ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. Condition is a should not be equal to 0. This is the general form actually, which I have written initially. So a should not be equal to 0, b and c both can be 0. So if a, b, c all are real numbers, if a, b, c all are real number, all are real numbers, or they can be complex numbers also. In few books he said that a comma b comma c, if they are complex, because real number is a subset of our complex numbers, which we have discussed in the previous class. So the roots will become rational only when a comma b comma c all belongs to R. I should say a comma b comma c belongs to R. A comma b comma c belongs to R. Roots will become what? Irrational. Suppose if a is equal to 1 and b comma c belongs to R, the roots are actually integers. This point is to be noted. It is very clearly given in your second grade material also. If you have time enough, if you have time, you can just go through these points which I'm discussing now. If all the three real numbers belongs to R, that means A may not be equal to 1. Specifically, suppose if A is equal to 1 and B comma C belongs to R, in that case, roots are actually what? Integers. Otherwise, roots will become rational numbers. Okay? So this is actually about the nature of the roots, how they behave. Right. Now, if I'm saying two roots, suppose if alpha comma b are the roots, ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. I can write on this one as a times plus c by a. What I'm doing now? A minus of minus b by a into x plus c by a. So this will become actually a into x square minus of alpha plus beta into x plus alpha beta. So this is the form actually in which we change. That is, every quadratic expression can be changed in this way. From this, it is concluded that alpha plus beta, which is called as sum of the roots, is nothing but minus b by a. Alpha beta, which is a product of the root, is written as c by a. In general, if you want to find out the equation whose roots are actually what? Alpha comma beta, we use this equation. X square minus of alpha plus beta into x plus alpha beta is equal to 0 is the quadratic equation whose roots are alpha comma beta. And this is the way actually how we derive. As we go on, you come across few questions where you need more information also. So based upon when those question comes, I will be giving the theory. In general, I will say now that if alpha comma beta are the roots, suppose if alpha comma beta are the roots of a quadratic equation, then the equation is x minus alpha into x minus beta equal to 0. So dear students, you should remember that if there are two roots, this is the way. This is the way to write down. If you multiply, you are getting the same bracket here, which is here. Similarly, if I extend this theory, like if there are three roots, alpha, beta, gamma, then you get x minus alpha, x minus beta, x minus gamma equal to 0. and so on, depending upon whatever number of roots. So many factors you have to multiply to get that equation, right? Please take it on. Now it has a very good meaning once we go deeper and deeper into the problems, because y equal to ax square plus bx plus c, even I say, if you just recall what we have learned, like in first year objective, that is y equal to ax square plus bx plus c is y equal to ax square plus bx plus c is the equation of the parabola which is open either upwards or downwards. Okay, so this is the equation of parabola whose axis is actually what, parallel to y axis. That's it. I mean, whatever we are doing here, the general form of a quadratic expression, it is a parabola, and we can do many questions when we go deeper and deeper up to advanced level. But I have started with the basics. Since you don't have much of the problems and models actually in your NCRT, we'll go step by step. I don't go directly into the depth of the subject. So here, I was discussing actually about the nature of the roots, right? And what is the quadratic equation? If there are two roots, then sum of the roots is given by minus b by a, and the product of the roots is given by what? C by a. Yes. Step by step, let us go. Let us do the problems. Problems are not so easy, I'm saying. It appears to be only very simple question like, okay, only one formula, no minus b plus or minus. But there will be actually a very big doubt when to use formula, when not to use formula. Suppose if at all I'm saying 3x square minus 9x plus 7 something equal to 0. For example, if I say, so when to go to formula, when not to go to formula is a very big actually question mark. For such students, what I generally say is, this you have to plan it earlier. You should see by that delta. What is delta? B square minus 4ac. B square minus 4ac is a perfect square. This is to be remembered, please. Is a perfect square. Okay. So when it is a perfect square, b square minus 4ac, then only you can factorize them. Factorize them in the sense what? You can get the factors. If it is not a perfect square, you should remember that, don't try to factorize. Try to use directly the formula. What is the formula? Minus b plus r minus under root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. So make it very clear. Go to factorization only when delta value is positive and a perfect square, where there is possibility of getting actually what? The integral roots. Did you understand this? When there is a possibility of getting actually integral roots, right? You can factorize. Or if not, directly use the formula. So this is actually about what the when to factorize and when to use the formula. So this is the basic thing required actually for to do initially few problems. As the days goes on, as the classes go on, I'll be giving theory wherever the question comes. I request every one of you to write down what all actually I'm giving the notes, what all actually I'm telling new points, because it is not at all there in your NCRT, right? I hope you have understood this. Right. Next, without wasting time, I just want to enter into the questions now, because there are many questions which appear to be very simple, but it's not so easy for you actually to solve. Such questions actually we have to try now. Okay. Now, if you just open your Cengage materials, right, I appeal to everyone that when I'm doing this like quadratic equation chapter, it is mandatory for you to just go through the each and every theory part of the Cengage material. Try to understand the formula, try to understand the meaning of that, go through the examples. It is your duty to work out the examples. Then only you can follow the Cengage materials here, right? So I start with the Cengage material. I just go with what? The first question. The first question of your Cengage material. Please take it out. Keep the Cengage materials before you and just see the first question. The question is, find the number of real solutions of, find the numbers of real solutions of 2x minus 4 root of 2x minus 4 minus under root of x plus 5 equal to 1. What the question here is, we should find the number of real solutions. Let us solve this problem. Let us see what is the answer. You know that this question exists only when whatever comes at the root is positive. Suppose if root of negative number comes, it becomes imaginary. And you can never, compare imaginary terms, right? So here, this question exists only when it satisfies two conditions. What is that? 2x minus 4 greater than or equal to 0. and x plus 5 get down equal to 0. Why? If it is less than 0, what happens is that becomes imaginary. So this implies actually implies x is get down equal to how much? 2. This implies x is get down equal to how much? Minus 5. So 2x get down equal to 4, x get down equal to 2. So from this 2, what can you conclude is you can write down, you should see which is bigger. So I can do directly, but the best way to do is if this is minus 5 and this is 2, you should see which is the set which occupies both the sets. So I should say, yeah, this is the one. This is the one, right? Right. So the common solution to both is what? X is greater than equal to 2. This is to be kept in mind. So whatever answer you get, it should be actually what? It should be greater than or equal to 2. Okay. Now how to solve it? Okay, I know that the answer which I'm getting, it should lie like greater than 2. I mean from 2 to infinity. So what we do now is I will write down under root of 2x minus 4 is equal to 1 plus under root of x plus 1. And remember, these are the problems which we come across in locus also. Whenever you are getting two roots only to one side, don't square it directly. For that purpose, what you have to do? Better take one square root to other side and square, so that the problem and the calculations will become easier. Now what you do is, you square on both the sides. If I square on both the sides, I am getting 2x minus 4 is equal to, I have to use here a plus b whole square formula. I get 1 plus x plus 5 plus 2 times of under root of what? X plus 5. So I am using a square plus b square plus 2ab. If I take all these terms to left side, I am getting 2x minus x is x. This is minus 10. This is equal to actually what? 2 times of under root of what? X plus 5. See here, the first question itself, the first question of your Cengage material itself, it's giving like, you know, somewhat explanation. And I'm using here the concept of functions chapter. What is the function chapter? What is the domain of this? Means this is the domain. If anyone asks what is the domain of this question here, I mean equation, I mean I have to say that x greater than equal to 2 is the domain. So a concept of function chapter is utilized where? In quadratic equations. And remember, such type of questions are important for the national level competitive examinations. So if I say I got x minus 10, x, 2x minus 6 is x, 1 plus 5 is 6, minus 4 minus 6 is minus 10. So I'm getting only one root 2, one root in RHS. Again, what do? I will take squaring on both sides. I'm getting x square minus 10x plus 100 is equal to 4 times of x plus 5. So this is the solution. So I'm getting now x square, this is minus 14x plus 80 equal to 0. 100 minus 20 is 80. So I should write down now, this is x minus 4 into x minus 10 is equal to 0. Because if I multiply, I'm getting minus of 4 plus 10 plus of 4 into, I mean, 4 minus 4, okay, which is 100 minus 20, 80. Okay. Minus 10 minus 4x minus 14x, 4 times of x plus 5. This is 28, sorry. So this is 20x, 24x, x minus 4 into x minus 20. Now this I am right. So I got the value of 4 actually. I got the value of x. X value is what? X is equal to 4. X is equal to how much? 20. X equal to 4. X equal to 20. Okay. It appears as if I got the answer. No doubt I got 4 and 20, both are greater than 2 itself. But immediately don't conclude that answer is 2. Don't say the number of real solutions are 2. No doubt I got here 2 answers. I got the answers, but I have to check for which answer the question exists. Suppose if I say x equal to 4. So what will happen now? This question changes to 0 minus root of 4 plus 3 equal to 1. What is the root of 4 plus 5? Sorry, root of 4 plus 5. So what I'm getting actually, minus 3 equal to 1, which is totally absurd, which is wrong. That means, though I got both the answers, x equal to 4, x equal to 2, greater than 2, x equal to 4, which is there, it will be eliminated. I will take now second case. What is that? X equal to 2. X equal to, sorry, 20. If we take x equal to 20, 22 is 40. 40 minus 4 is how much? 36. I am getting 6. x equal to what? 20. 20 plus 5 is 25. 225 is how much? 5. I am getting 6 minus 5 equal to 1, which is correct. And therefore, there is only one solution which satisfies that. What is that? X equal to 20. Because x equal to 4 does not satisfy the given equation. And therefore, the number of real solutions of this equation which is given is equal to what? Only one real solution. And that solution is what? X is equal to 20. Please take it on. I move on to third question now. Number of irrational roots of 4x by 5. Let's make it faster. The question was, find the number of real solutions of 4x by, this is x square plus x plus 3 plus 5x by x square minus 5x plus 3 is equal to minus 3 by. I have to find out number of irrational roots. See, question appears to be a little bit more complicated because if you go on solving, you are getting degree 4 and whatnot, degree, I mean many things. And from this, it will be difficult for you to solve, to find out number of irrational roots, how many are rational, what are the questions will be. For this, to make the question simpler, you have to observe one important point. You have to see that in both the quadratic equations, x square term and the constant terms are same. When these two terms are same, then the problems can be solved in a simple way. So when it becomes very complicated for you to go for calculation, you have to look out for these two terms, please. X square term and the constant term. If they are same, problem will become easier. That is, what do? I will divide numerator and denominator by x. So that the problem becomes easier. I get here 4 by x plus 1 plus 3 by x plus this is x, sorry, 5 by this is 5 by x minus 5 plus 3 by x equal to how much? Minus 3 by 2. If you observe this here, after doing this, when you are dividing both numerator and denominator by what? Dividing by x, then you will be getting these two terms which are common. What are that? What is that? X plus 3 by x. Now if you imagine that x plus 3 by x, what is that? Put x plus 3 by x is equal to t. So that this will make the problem easier for us. You get 4 by t plus 1 plus 5 by t minus 5 equal to how much? Minus 3 by t. See, the question was a little bit complicated because there was quadratic expression in the denominator and so on. But by using this simple technique, I have made the denominators in terms of a single linear term, I mean linear expression, t plus 1, t minus 5. The only thing is I have to find out the values of t now and simplify. Come on, I hope you can do this. Those who are able to do, you do it parallelly along with me. So what will happen is, if I simplify, I get 4t minus 20 plus 5t plus 5 times of 2 is equal to minus 3. This is t square minus, this is minus 4t minus 5. I have taken LCM and have cross multiplied directly. 4 into t minus 5 is 4t minus 20 plus 5t plus 5 multiplied by 2 minus 3 times of. I have multiplied t plus 1 t minus 5. T plus 1 t minus 5 is what? T square minus 4t. Product is how much? Minus 5. So I am getting actually here, this is 8t minus 40 plus 10t plus 10 is equal to, this is minus 3t square plus 12t and plus 15. Okay, if I take to left side, it becomes 3t square, 10 plus 8, 18, 18 minus 12 is 60, minus 40 plus 10, minus 30, minus 30 minus 15 is minus 45. Is equal to 0. I can divide it by 3. T square plus 2t minus 15 is equal to 0. Hence, I will be getting t plus 5 into t minus 3 equal to 0. I get the value of t as minus 5 comma 3. Okay. So, if I get the value of t as minus 5, I will take first case. What is t as minus 5 means? X plus 3 by x is equal to minus 5. What do I get actually is x square plus 5x plus 3 equal to 0. Right. What about delta value here? Delta value is b square minus 4ac, which is clearly greater than 0. B square is 25 minus 4 into 3 is 12, which is equal to 13, greater than 0. I am getting it for what? For x plus 3x equal to minus 5. Similarly, if I take x plus 3yx equal to how much? 3. I am getting x square minus 3x plus 3 equal to 0. So if I am find here delta, delta value is b square 9 minus 12, which is clearly less than 0. So here, if you observe this, that you are getting two different types of solutions. For first type, I am getting delta greater than 0. For second type, I am getting delta less than 0. The question is, find the number of irrational roots, he says. So you get irrational roots for what? For delta greater than 0 itself. Right? For delta less than 0, you are getting imaginary roots. And therefore, the number of irrational roots which we get here is only when t value is minus 5. And therefore, number of irrational roots is equal to how much? 2. Number of irrational roots is 2 here. And if you ask how many are imaginary, you will say 2. Because they occur in pairs, number of irrational roots or imaginary roots can be either 2, 4, 6, 8, like that. So there are 2 irrational roots and 2 roots are imaginary. So this was question number 3. So many used to ask me this, how to solve this type of question, sir. Question number 4. The question is, find the value of this. X equal to 2 plus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 plus going up to infinity. I have to find this value. Make it fast. These are only calculations. Okay. See here, To find this value, it is going up to infinity. What's that? 2 plus 1 by 2 plus 1, 1 by 2 plus and so on. And everyone should remember that infinity minus 1 or infinity minus any defined value. Please note this point. Any defined number is always equal to infinity. Any defined term, whatever number we know, if you subtract it from infinity, answer will be always equal to infinity. So infinity minus 1 is also equal to what? Infinity only. Nothing will happen if you remove minus 1 or if you do minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 100, minus 1 lakh, minus 1 crore, whatever it is, the value will be same. So to solve this, we use this concept itself. I will use the first one. Infinity minus 1 equal to what? Infinity. What do I do? I will write this. I will take this value as x is equal to, I will write 2 plus 1 by. If I remove this, if I remove from here, again it appears as if what? 2 plus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 plus, it appears to be same question itself. So I can write this one as what now? X. X equal to 2 plus 1 by x. Why? I have removed only this part. What is that? This part I have removed. This part only I have removed. Again I am getting 2. Again I am getting 2 plus 1 by 2 plus. So this will become, so it is x equal to 2 plus 1 by x. If I simplify, I get x square minus 2x plus 1 is equal to 0. It is not plus 1. It is actually minus 1 equal to 0. X value is minus b plus r minus under root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. B square is 4, minus 4ac means minus 4 into minus minus 4. So I am getting x value as 2 plus r minus 2 root 2 by 2, because I am getting root 8 there. This will be actually 1 plus r minus root 2. 1 plus r minus root 2. But if you observe this here, x value is 2 plus. So x value cannot be equal to 1 minus root 2. Why? 1 minus root 2 will become smaller. X equal to 2 plus something. No. This implies x value is 1 plus root 2. Write down the answer. The value of x is 1 plus root 2. This was question number 4 from your Cengage material. Make it fast, please. Next. Question number 9. Suppose you have a polynomial f of x. If it is divided by x minus 1 and x minus 2, it gives remainder of what? Remainder of 2 and 1. That is, suppose f of x is a polynomial. According to question, if f of x is divided by x minus 1, remainder is 2. Remainder is 2. If f of x is divided by x minus 2, remainder is 1. And you know actually from remainder theorem, if f of x is divided by x minus a, then the remainder is what? F of a. According to that, this implies f of 1 should be equal to 2 and f of 2 should be equal to 1. So what do you do actually is, you will see from options, this question can be solved in a simple way using options. The question is, what is the remainder you obtain when you divide the polynomial f of x by x minus 1 into x minus 2? Before going to that question itself, we can finish the problem. You should see from options, for which option you are getting f of 1 equal to 2 and f of 2 is equal to what? 1. So if you see there, you have option 1, 3 minus x. Option 1 is what? 3 minus x. What is f of 1 here? 2. What is f of 2 here? 1. And therefore, without going deeper, you can conclude that option 1 is correct. Please take it on. How do we get it? From remainder theorem. What does it say? That if a function f of x is divided by x minus a, then the remainder is f of a. According to that, we get this. Question number 9. Next. I move on to question number 11 now from your syntax material. The question says this. He had given nth degree polynomial equation. What is that? X power of n minus 1. X power of n minus 1 equal to 0. The roots of this equation are 1, alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha n minus 1. We should find the value of 1 minus alpha 1, 1 minus alpha 2, 1 minus alpha 3, so up to what? Up to 1 minus of alpha n minus 1. Okay, to solve this, what do? I will take one important formula. I will deduce that also. See, that's what I'm saying. Whenever I get the situation wherein I need to give important point, I'm giving you here one important point for this problem. Many problems come into this category. Many problems I'm talking about advanced also. For all those things, this is the important concept which I'm going to give you. Please make a note of that. Everyone knows x square minus 1 equal to what? X minus 1 into x plus 1. And x cube minus 1 is equal to x minus 1 into x square plus x plus 1. Why? 1 can be taken as 1 square and 1 cube also. Right? So this is everyone knows. When we feel that only these are the formulae, they can be extended. If I had an x power 4 minus 1, this will become x minus 1 into, it should start with x cube plus x square plus x plus 1. And so on. If I write down x power of n minus 1, so it has actually what? x power of n minus 1 plus x power of n minus 2 plus so on up to x square plus x plus 1. Please note on this formula. Furthermore, you can write this one also. X square minus 1 equal to x minus 1 into x plus 1. This is another set of formula, please. This is the first set. Next, x cube minus 1 equal to x minus 1 into x minus alpha 1 into x minus alpha 2. This is in general. See, when I do like this, I'm getting a quadratic. If I'm doing for x power 4 minus 1, I'm getting a cubic, but I don't know what it is. This formula also will be used in different problems. May not be here, but in future. But if you want to know specifically, if he has given specifically the roots, then you have to use the second set of formulae. And these are the set of formulae. With this formula, I will solve this question number 11. What are these now? 1, alpha 1, alpha 2, if these are the roots. Suppose if I say x power 4 minus 1, how many roots will be there? 4 roots. From among them, one root is actually what? 1, x minus alpha 1, x minus alpha 2, x minus alpha 3. So there are 4 roots. What are they? 1, alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha 3. And so on. If I write down x power of n minus 1, this can be written as actually x minus 1 into x minus alpha 1 into x minus alpha 2 into so on, x minus of alpha n minus 1. So this is the formula which we will be using in this problem number 11. See, this is the first set of formulae which can be used like in further problems. And the second set of formulae which I have given will be used here. Especially the last formula will be used here. I was just saying you that if you want to get degree 4 equation, so x minus alpha, x minus beta, x minus gamma, x minus delta, like that, degree n equation, x power of n minus 1 can be written like this. Why I'm writing like this? Because he says that 1, alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha n minus 1 are the roots of this equation. If 1, alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha n are the roots of a nth degree equation, its general form is this. General form is given as what? X power of n minus 1. Further simplifying, I will be getting the answer. I hope you have taken this. Make it faster so that I can go to the problem now. This is question number 11. I have given two types of formulae. Second type of formula I will be using here. So this is called as equation number 1. Okay, what do we do now? Here, from one, if you see, from equation number one, I'll write x power of n minus 1 by x minus 1 is equal to, I get x minus alpha 1, x minus alpha 2, so on, x minus alpha n minus 1. What I have done here, from this formula, I have taken x minus 1 to what? Left side. I get x power of n minus 1 by x minus 1. Now what do I do now? Take limit as x tending to 1. I'm using the concept of here limits to solve the problem in an easier way. What do I do is, I will write down limit x tending to 1. X power of n minus 1 by x minus 1 is equal to limit x tending to 1. I get x minus alpha 1, this is x minus alpha 2, so on, x minus of alpha n minus 1. Why I am taking like this? Because if I take x tending to 1, I get 1 minus 1 0 by 0, which is actually what? The indeterminate form. And whenever you get the indeterminate form, like 0 by 0 or infinity by infinity, you have learned that you can use L'Hospital's rule, so that the problem will become easier for us to solve. We take the help of here the derivatives. So if I use the L'Hospital's rule here, I have to differentiate both numerator and denominator. So I'm getting limit x tending to 1, derivative for numerator is n into x power of n minus 1 by 1. I'm using L'Hospital's rule. If I substitute here x equal to 1, I will be getting here 1 minus alpha 1, 1 minus alpha 2, so on, 1 minus of alpha n minus 1, which is actually our question, So if I substitute n equal to 1 here, I get 1 minus alpha 1, 1 minus alpha 2, so on up to 1 minus alpha n minus 1 is equal to n into 1 power of n minus 1, which is equal to what? N. And therefore, the answer for this question number 11 from your Sengage material is, yeah, take it out. Next. I move on to question number 13. He's saying find the least value of x square plus 4y square plus 3z square minus 2x minus 1y minus 6z plus 14 equal to 0. I have to find the least value of this. To find the least value of this, it's not so easy to solve unless and until you solve this. You solve this degree 2 equation. It is degree 2 equation actually. So what do I do now? To solve this, I take x square minus 2x, x square minus 2x plus 1. Next, 4y square. Now, I will write down 4y square minus 12y. It becomes 2y whole square minus 2 into 2 into 2. 4 into 3 is 12. Now, so I should write down plus 9 here. And modifying this, plus 3z square minus 12z. So 3, if I take root 3, it becomes irrational. I take 3 common. I get z square minus 2y plus 1. See, for this, 3z square minus 6z, if I take root 3z whole square, root 3 will become irrational. So I kept 3 outside. I'm getting z square minus 2z. I'm adding plus 1 because I can use the formula a minus b whole square. If you observe this here, x square plus 4y square plus 3z square is correct. Now minus 2x. Minus 2x is okay. Minus 12y is also okay. Minus 6y is also okay. Now I have to balance 14. I got 1. 1 plus 9, 10. 10 plus 3, 13. Plus how much? 1. Extra, I should get here 1. So if you observe this here, I get x minus 1 whole square plus this is 2y minus 3 whole square plus this is 3 times of z minus 1 whole square plus 1 equal to 0. If you observe this here, all these values are positive. What are those? This x minus 1 whole square, 2y minus 3 whole square, 3 into z minus 1 whole square. All these values are greater than or equal to 0. No, greater than or equal to 0. So if you want to get the least value, we get the least value only when these values become 0. So we get the least value. Least value we get at the point what? At 1, 3 by 2, 1. If x equal to 1, it becomes 0. If y equal to 3 by 2, it becomes 0. If z equal to 1, it becomes 0. If I substitute this point here, I get 0 plus 0 plus 0 plus 1. So and that least value will become actually what? 0 plus 0 plus 0 plus 1, which is called how much? 1. And therefore, the least value of this rectangle, the least value of this equation is 0. It should be expressions, the least value of expression it should be. Take it up. This was question number 13. I move on to question number 18 now. It says, if the equation, question number 18, x square plus 2 times of mod a into x plus 4 equal to 0. X square plus 2 times of mod x plus 4 equal to 0 has integral roots. It has integral roots. What's the meaning of that? Roots are integers. Then the minimum value of a. Minimum value of a equal to question mark. This is the question. X square plus 2 times of mod x. 2 mod a into x plus 4 equal to 0. Has for this you need to go with the options actually. Okay, what is given here? What is given? Given equation is x square plus 2 times of mod a into x plus 4 equal to 0. I will find out what is delta value here. Let us see what is delta value. Delta value is b square 4 mod a whole square minus 16, minus 4 into 4, 16. Okay, if it has integral roots, then delta value should be greater than 0, no? Delta greater than 0. This implies 4 into mod a square minus 16 greater than 0. So mod a square greater than how much? 4. Mod a value is less than minus 2. Mod a value is greater than 2. From linear inequalities, the concept. If you didn't understand this, I will go in detail. Because it is this you might have learned in linear inequalities concept in your NCERT itself. I'll write this one as mod a plus 2 into how much? Mod a minus 2 greater than 0. X minus alpha and x minus beta greater than 0 means what do we get? X less than alpha, x greater than beta. Mod a value less than minus 2, it's not at all acceptable. Mod a value can be greater than 2. If you observe there the options should be 0, 4, minus 4, some minus 5 by 2. And therefore, the answer is here 0, minus 4, minus 5 by 2. It becomes greater than 2 means you should get actually minus 5 by 2. Because modulus of minus 5 by 2 is how much? 2.5, which is greater than 2. And therefore, answer is minus 5 by 2. Take it on this one. The other three options, they do not satisfy the criteria. 4 minus 4 is there. But the least value is actually minus 2.5, minus 5 by 2, because modulus of minus 2.5 is what? 2.5. So this was question number 18. Next, I'll go on to question number 24. move on to question number 24. Find the roots of S. You have to find the roots of a power 4 plus b power 4 into x square plus 4abcdx plus c power 4 plus d power 4 equal to 0. You have to find here the nature of the roots also. According to different options, the roots are real if it satisfies some condition and other things are there. It's not so easy to find to solve this degree 4 because you had given a degree 4. And if you see the options, there is no need to find the roots. Only by checking the nature, you can give the answer. You have to check the nature here. To check the nature, what is it you have to do? You should find out delta. What is delta? B square minus 4s. So if I take to question number 24, I mean solution for this, I'll find out delta. What is delta? B square minus 4s. This is 16 a square b square c square d square minus 4 times of a power 4 plus b power 4 into c power 4 plus d power 4. This is actually what delta value. So what do I do now? I will write down this one as minus 4 comma, because this is degree, this is bigger, no? This should be positive, the other will be negative, because in a plus b whole square, a minus b whole square, a square plus b square is common. Plus r minus 2, plus r minus 2ab should be common. A square should be positive, means higher term should be positive. This should be positive, or take minus 4 common. If I take minus 4 common, I get a power 4 c power 4 plus a power 4 d power 4 plus b power 4 c power 4 plus b power 4 d power 4. This is minus 4 I have taken, no? I will take minus 4 once again. If I take minus 4 into minus 4 becomes plus 16, I will be getting here a square, b square, c square, d square. So this will become actually minus 4 times of, okay, so here a square, c square, b square, d square. Yeah, these two I will take. These two and these two. So what I will do, I will take a power 4 c power 4 plus b power 4 d power 4 minus 2 times of a square b square c square d square. This I will take it as one bracket plus I will take the remaining. This is a power 4 d power 4 a power 4 d power 4, yeah, plus b power 4 c power 4 minus 2 times of a square b square c square d square. Yes, see, I'm using a minus b whole square formula two times here, first for this. So what I'm getting is, I get minus 2 minus 2, that gives you minus 4. This will be written as minus 4 times of, I can write this one as a square c square minus b square d square whole square. If I expand this, I'm getting the same bracket above. So a square c square minus b square d square whole square. I get a power 4 c power 4 b power 4 d power 4 minus 2 times. Similarly here, if I use this, I get a square b square, this is minus b square c square whole square. I get like this. Okay, so this will be actually minus 4 times of, if you observe whatever it is always positive, no? This can be less than or equal to 0. Why? Square and square will never be negative. So negative into positive is always negative, or at the max it can be less than or equal to 0. That means clearly I can say that the roots can be imaginary or the roots can be equal. So if roots are equal, then only I should say here that roots cannot be different if real. According to the option, he says this is the condition. Roots are equal, then only the roots are real. There are two cases actually. What is that? The roots are real and equal, and the roots are imaginary. What is the meaning of that? That the roots cannot be different if they are real. Cannot be different means what? The roots are equal if they are real, and therefore the option, the roots cannot be different if they are real, is correct. Hence, this is the solution. This was question number 24.
Sir, yes sir, okay.
Do you want me to stop, sir?
Yes sir, stop.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, students, will in this class, this we have been up to question number 24. We have got different questions coming by, new theory also coming by. So see that you are here in next class. Until then, see you. Bye bye.